welcome back. Israel, are you ready? It's down to you three. South Africa, India, and Paraguay. Now, ladies, this is the moment that you've been working towards for years. And there's just one more challenge in front of you. It is the final question challenge. And it's pure head-to-head competition. As unlike the last round, I'm going to ask each of you the exact same question. You will each have 30 seconds to respond, and your answer will help determine who will become the next Miss Universe. Now, while one contestant answers, the others will be wearing soundproof headphones. It's a level playing field. Each one of you has the exact same chance to win. And simply put, it's up to you to rise to the moment. You've each got 30 seconds to answer. If you go over the time, you will hear this sound. An interpreter will be provided if requested, and that time will not be counted in the 30 seconds. So headphones on. South Africa, come on over. Here is the question. What advice would you give to young women watching on how to deal with the pressures they face today?
I would implore young women today to choose courage over comfort every opportunity they get. I'd also like young women to know that since the beginning of time, they've had everything within them to achieve anything they've wanted. It was unfortunately the world that convinced us that we did not. Thank you.
Thank you. India, please join. What advice would you give to young women watching on how to deal with the pressures they face today?
Well, I think the biggest pressure the youth of today is facing is to believe in themselves. To know that you are unique and that's what makes you beautiful. Stop comparing yourselves with others and let's talk about more important things that's happening worldwide. I think this is what you need to understand. Come out, speak for yourself because you are the leader of your life. You are the voice of your own. I believe in myself and that's why I'm standing here today. Thank you.
Paraguay, please join. Is the question. What advice would you give to young women how to deal with the pressures they face today?
¿Qué consejos darías a las mujeres jóvenes que están viendo la competencia sobre cómo lidiar con las presiones que se enfrentan hoy?
I've been through so many hard situations in my life, but I overcome it. So I want all women, all persons who is watching in this moment to join forces, to do what you meant to do, because you can do it. No matter the situation, you can overcome it and you can always be victorious. Thank you.
Thank you. Well, we have three ambitious women, all confident, all uniquely talented. Now, while the selection panel is getting ready to decide who answered it in the best way befitting the next Miss Universe, let's check in with Chesley and Carson to get their reaction.
Okay, it all comes down to this final question. It's been neck and neck. You know, I was rooting for Paraguay, Queer Eye for the Paraguay. But I think after that, I think South Africa and India maybe had a stronger performance in that final question.
I have to agree with you. I mean, South Africa, a degree in law as an attorney. Girl, I see you. That was an incredible answer.
I do not object.
Thank you. I'm glad to know. So, well, Carson, I mean, the time has come. We're at the end of the pageant. I need to know, who is your winner?
I'm gonna say India.
Okay. Any reason?
I love that gown. That's shallow.
India,
I know.
Because she's got good fashion, so I'm okay with that.
You know, I love the gown.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, really. Well, if I had to pick right now, I would say South Africa.
Okay, why?
Like I said, the attorneys, we stick together,
okay.
Lady. And she gave a great answer that I think resonates with a lot of people listening at home.
Agreed. Well, coming up, our three finalists have one more chance to shine, one more chance to impress the selection panel in the final look.
And then the big moment.